I'm also interested to see who else is going to be in the playoffs, because if you look at the hottest teams in the NHL since January 14th, they are the Philadelphia Flyers and the St. Louis Blues. We know the Blues have now moved themselves into a playoff spot. The Flyers, a little tougher because they're in the East, where teams haven't struggled so mightily at the bottom of the conference. But, I mean, I never would have thought 6 weeks ago, 8 weeks ago, that in February the two hottest teams in the league would be the Flyers and the Blues. Because they were written off a long time ago,
these
let's be honest.
These two analysts have on this air many times over the course of the last several weeks referred to the Blues and to the Flyers as, you know, it's not their year. They're kind of a forgotten commodity.
Don't say that. Nobody will remember.
It's not on tape anywhere.
How off the mark the analysis was.
I mean, they both fire their coaches. They've both, you know, gone through goaltenders. I mean, these are two teams that have battled through a lot of adversity this year.
Yeah, they really have. And for the Philadelphia Flyers, you saw right there, and that's that. They are the hottest team, but they are not like the Blues in the playoffs. And when I say Blues, I mean like the Blues comfortably in the playoffs.
Well, they don't have the luxury of being
like
surrounded by the Oilers and the Ducks
and all these teams. And you got to tip your cap to the Flyers. But the fact of the matter is, it's going to be incredibly difficult for them to make up the ground that they still need to make up. Can they do it? Of course they can. Just win all your games. They'll be in the playoffs if that happens. But the run they've been on, and to continue it, you know, for another 20 games, 25 games that they probably need to, that's going to be really difficult.
Well, and it's a statement to just how competitive the Eastern Conference is right now. They're 6 points back with nearly, well, probably 20 games or better to make it up. But I'll tell you what, the way things have gone in the East, that's a lot of ground to cover. Different if you're in the West, but they're not. Important part of the explanation is a young fella that wasn't supposed to start in the NHL this year. I refer to him as, not Carter, Starter Hart
like
has
that.
Been rather remarkable this year. Really his first full year of professional hockey, and I think the inclination, the plan, really under Ron Hextall regime, was Hart's going to get a full year in the minors. Goaltending is a different trade to learn. It may look like that in retrospect, but I don't know. I think I would have stuck with it if I was him.
Well, look no further than Jordan Binnington in St. Louis.
Right.
A guy that was drafted in 2011. A guy that, quite frankly, was on loan last year to the Providence Bruins because he was so far down the goaltending depth in St. Louis. So it can take a long time. It traditionally does take a lot longer time, and you're traditionally better off if you can wait. In Carter Hart's case, though, he's proven that, hey, guys, should have had me up first opportunity. Things might have been different. Binnington, though, is a great story.
Another goaltender I've rebranded. It's actually Jordan Winnington.
Yes.
All that boy does is win.
No matter what. Do you guys even know that song?
You got to get him another job. You got all this free time.
I don't know
think of these things.
When you got a week
you
off between on
Everyone
air, you got a little time
song.
to.